Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Hearty welcome to each one of you to this Eucharist. Today is the feast of St. John Marie Vianney, the patron of all parish priests, all priests and pastoral clergy. Pray for our priests today in a very special way. And happy feast to all our priests. I'm offering this Mass for you. Especially the ones who are old, aged, all of you, each one of you. God loves you and we all care for you. Many intentions over here. It's Wednesday and let's keep these intentions also in our mind. Deep faith people ask, thanksgiving for my daughter, 2 years of coming into my life, for receiving a promotion, from a cure from a very bad cold, fever and cough, for smooth visa application, for safe COVID vaccination, for all the favors and blessings received through your grace, for my elder daughter's promotion, for all medical reports coming clear, sister-in-law, getting a job, chef's job, elder son after 18 months, my younger son, advertising firm, receiving a high percentage in 12th standard, getting admission in my preferred college. Thanks our God for his continued care, protection of my son from his kidney transplant on the 3rd of August 2009, 12 years back. We thank God for that. For my wound healing after surgery, taking care of us so well in spite of challenges in the COVID time. For admission, daughter get admission in TIS, this 14 Thanksgivings. We thank God for all the favors, God's blessings. For those who have passed away, there are 12, for souls of the D'Souzas and Dennis Charles. For my father, passed on the 2nd of August 2007, my eldest cousin from Malad, expired on 29th of June 21. 29th of July was my father's 4th death anniversary. The soul of so-and-so on the 30th of July 2021. Soul of, again, Castellino, 31st of July. My father, on his 44th death anniversary, on the 3rd of August, 21. This is from the husband for the wife, on the 4th of August, Rodericks. My father passed away on the 4th of August, 2019. My mother, second death anniversary, on the 4th of August. My father's 14th death anniversary on the 5th of August. My husband's 2nd death anniversary on the 5th of August. We pray all for all these 12 intentions, people who have passed away. Intentions for good health, spiritual well-being, well-being of the Holy Father, Cardinal Priest, etc. As a feast of St. John Marie Vianney. Again, good health and success for Pope Francis, Cardinal Gracious, bishops, clergy, religious, lay faithful. Again, recovery, well-being for Pope Francis, Cardinal Gracious and his team. Well-being of the Cardinal, entire team, the choirs. For good health of the family. good health of my family. Family's good health and financial crisis, healing of a 3-year-old girl, leg burns, ear to open up normally, healing from knee pain, arthritis, recovery of my legs, cure of piles and cyst, healing of my throat pains, success for the removal of a syringe, the needle broke in the person's leg, pray that they trace it and are able to remove it. My brother had a heart attack 10 days back, to be healed physically, emotionally. My mother, whom he has been taking care of, advanced stage of dementia. My own health, not good, sugar levels, thyroid levels, and BP high. My aunt in the hospital, ICU and sick, blood clot in the brain. My 8-year-old girl, severe stomach pain, headache many days, is in the hospital, fever, delirium, shivering. My close friend, 40-year-old male, suffering low back pain, 3 years. Good health and peace in the family, bypass surgery of my husband. Success of surgery and quick recovery of so-and-so. We pray for these 23 intentions for recovery and from health case. And the others few. For the family, suitable room for my daughter to be, befriend the right people, come back to God, obtain family visa in the UK. For good and God-fearing life, part of my elder daughter. To solve our financial problems, have peace, prosperity and understanding. Peace and reconciliation of my son and the wife, married only for 2 years, may they understand each other. Family may be united. My daughter to conceive, have a healthy baby. For jobs, my daughter to secure admission, right college, help her choose right subjects after 12th standard. Daughter's visa to work in the Hilton Hotel has been delayed. My son to be able to travel to Canada, studies. Approval of my student visa, husband's open work, Canada. My DCG exam portal opens earliest. Receive my exam for being commercial pilot. For my husband, enrollment in the master's course. Birthdays, anniversaries, my grandmother, age 70 years on 22nd of July, 35th birthday of so-and-so on the 29th of July. My daughter, 29th birthday on the 3rd of August. My mother's birthday, 3rd of August. My daughter celebrating a 21st birthday on the 2nd of August. My son's 21st birthday, 31st of July. My mother, 90th birthday on the 4th of August. My grandmother, 76th birthday on the 5th of August. And finally, the last few, for wisdom in handling property matters in Goa, getting OC from a 20-year-old house, help me sell my flat in Bombay and house in Goa to buy a flat in my daughter's house in Mumbai. Amicable settlement of my property dispute. Case in high courts upheld. Immigration in Canada, get affirmative response. We pray for all these intentions. And during the canon, I'll pray for those who are passed away. And now let's begin our sacrifice, asking God's forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You come to make all things new. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, who made the priest, St. John Marie Vianney, wonderful in his pastoral zeal, grant we may through his intercession and his example, we may in charity win brothers and sisters for Christ, attain with them eternal glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly sit for the reading.
A reading from the book of Numbers. In those days, the Lord spoke to Moses in the wilderness of Paran, saying, "Send men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I am giving to the people of Israel. From each tribe of their fathers you shall send a man, every one a chief among them." At the end of 40 days they returned from spying out the land, and they came to Moses and Aaron, and to all the congregation of the people of Israel in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh. They brought back word to them and to all the congregation and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him, "We came to the land to which you sent us. It flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. However, the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the city are fortified and very large. And besides, we saw the descendants of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the Negeb. The Hittites, the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the hill country, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and along the Jordan." But Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and occupy it, for we are well able to overcome it." Then the men who had gone up with him said, "We are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we are." So they brought to the people of Israel a bad report of the land that they had spied on, saying, "The land through which we have gone to spy it out is the land that devours its inhabitants, and all the people that we saw in it are of great height. And there we saw the Nephilim, the son of Anak, who come from the Nephilim, and we seemed to ourselves like grasshoppers, and so we seemed to them." Then all the congregation raised a loud cry, and the people wept that night. And the Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "How long shall this wicked congregation grumble against me? I have heard the grumblings of the people of Israel, which they grumble against me. Say to them, 'As I live, declares the Lord, what you have said in my hearing, I will do to you. Your dead bodies shall fall in this wilderness, and of all your number listed in the census from 20 years old and upwards, who have grumbled against me, according to the number of the days in which you spied out the land, 40 days, a year for each day, you shall bear your iniquity for 40 years, and you shall know my displeasure. I, the Lord, have spoken. Surely, this will I do to all this wicked congregation who are gathered together against me. In this wilderness they shall come to a full end, and there they shall die." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. Altogether, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. Like our fathers, we have sinned. We have done wrong. Our deeds have been evil. Our forebears, when they were in Egypt, did not grasp the meaning of your wonders. Our response, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. But they soon forgot his deeds and would not wait upon his counsel. They yielded to their cravings in the desert and put God to the test in the wilderness. Our response, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. They forgot the God who was their savior, who had done such great things in Egypt, such wonders in the land of Ham, such marvels at the Red Sea. Our response, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. For this is he who said he would destroy them, but Moses, the man he had chosen, stood in the breach before him to turn back his anger from destruction. Our response, O Lord, remember us with the favor you show to your people. Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has risen among us, and God has visited his people. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus went away and withdrew to the district of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and was crying, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, Son of David. My daughter is severely oppressed by a demon." But he did not answer a word. And his disciples came and begged him, saying, "Send her away, for she is crying out after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." And he answered, "It is not right to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "O woman, great is your faith. Be done for you as you desire." And her daughter was healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers, my dear sisters, both the readings of today are about trust in God, about faith in God. The long reading, the first reading, which is taken from the Old Testament, speaks about the Israelites still on their way to the holy, to the promised land. The reading is from the book of Numbers, verse chapter 13. It's long, if you want to read it again. It tells the story of how now they have come close to the promised land, and God advises Moses, send some spies to see how that land is. Is it nice? How are the people? How are... is it conquerable? And bring a report. And they were frightened. They did not trust the Lord. And because they were frightened and did not trust the Lord, they began to feel, give reports that those people are very big. We are like grasshoppers in front of them. Totally exaggerations. All because they were afraid to go and combat. We know that Lord finally, they overcome all that. And they had seen so often the hand of the Lord. He had worked wonders when they were in Egypt. On the way, he had fed them. Continuously, he keeps on protecting them, giving them water. When they were in difficulties, when there were snakes, again the bronze serpent, repeatedly he came to their rescue. It was very clear that he was with them. And yet, in spite of that human nature, I suppose, they began to get frightened at this last moment. And this was insulting to the Lord, not putting their full faith and full trust in him. The gospel again is a question of trust. This lady, this Samaritan, this Canaanite woman, she comes over there and she's crying out to the Lord, "Save me, save me. My daughter is severely possessed by a demon." She was possessed. And she was a Canaanite, and therefore she was not a Jew. And therefore she was, Jesus had consistently told, when he sent his apostles, remember, he said, "Go only to the lost of Israel, only go there, only the Jews." It was a complete, very clear strategy in the mission. He did not want perhaps even to break his own commandments and moral instructions to his apostles himself by ignoring it. And so he didn't respond to her for a long time, just left her alone. And then he says something which I think I should explain. He says something which seems rude to our English language, English ears, in the sense that you can't give to the dogs what is given to the, meant for the children. It was not the term used in Aramaic was meant pets. The word, there were different words for different, the word was used was a pet. It's not right to give children's food to the pets, give it to the children. And now it sounds a little more palatable, a little more understanding. He meant first feed your children and then feed the pets. That was the idea. It was not the word used was not insulting or derogatory. That's why she kept on really, and what she said was true. Even children, the dogs, the pets eat what has fallen from the master's, called the master. Therefore, there was a relationship between the dog and the dogs which were there and the master of the house. And Jesus answers her because of the faith. And so faith, that's very, really important, faith. We must learn to have faith, must learn to deepen our faith and our commitment to the Lord. St. John Marie Vianney was one of the sort whose feast we celebrate today. And every pastoral priest is called to have faith, trust in the Lord. There are challenges in the priesthood, there are difficulties in the priesthood, there are problems which arise in a parish, with your bishop perhaps, with your companions, but trust in the Lord. The Lord, you're answering the Lord, you're not answering an individual or even the church. It's a personal relationship that Jesus is important. And that's what St. John Marie Vianney did. He was born in the 18th century, 1786, in a town near Lyons, and he was not, there was a time of persecution, and the Catholics and priests were being even imprisoned, some were being killed, and there was not a healthy atmosphere to have good faith and to want to become a priest. But his family remained faithful, because a good family brings good priests, and a family remained faithful, and therefore he desired really to join the seminary. But his big difficulty was that he was not very clever. He couldn't study Latin. And so he was trained, not in the seminary where he was for theology, but by his own, by a parish priest. The bishop sent him because he found him so, a devoted man, dedicated man, boy, young man, wanting to become a priest. And so he stayed with this parish priest in Bali, and he taught him theology not in Latin, but in French, because he couldn't understand the theology in French. Finally, when they went to the bishop, who was a cardinal then, they asked there's this young man who wants to, he's very religious and very pious and very doing all his exercise and religion, but he doesn't know much of theology. And the cardinal said, he's religious, that's enough for me, I will ordain him. And so he was ordained a priest and sent 2 years with the same one who had trained him. And then he was sent to a small village of Ars, where he became parish priest. And there, the bishop told him, there's not much love for God in that place, and there's much of worldliness, but you try to give them some God, some sense of God. And that's what he did. He was there for almost 40 years in the same parish. And this small parish, I think it was less than 400 people, a small village, he, by his preaching, by his life of prayer, by his complete trust in the Lord and everything, he transformed them completely. He worked very, very hard. He would pray for hours. They say he was very devoted to the confessional. Sometimes he would sit in the confessional, this one would say, for 15 hours. Now, I was saying there were less than 400 people, but they said there were afterwards, people began flocking to come for confession from the rest of France, even from other countries, neighboring countries, because they heard here was a very holy man. And the government had to arrange buses to bring people. There were so many people coming from all over, and made a total transformation in the place. They said it became a holy place. He had the gift of being able to see into a person his holiness or his difficulties. So they would come for confession, and he would immediately be able to tell them what they needed even before they confessed their sins. He was able to, and that really completely, I mean, they knew he was a holy man. They say people are quietly cutting off bits of his cassock and to take as relics, because there was a saint they knew. And he suffered a lot, I must share with you. According to the biography they've written, he, in his room, the devil sometimes troubled him, and the bed would start moving. His bed caught fire a couple of times. There were mysterious things happening of that sort, but he fully trusted, not afraid, trusted in the Lord, worked hard. And so he's the patron of all parish priests. And we pray today, please, for all your priests. Pray for me, pray for the bishops, but pray in a particular way for your parish priest, your assistants, that they're able to be, like Cure de Al, dedicated to you, to the church, and real friends of Jesus. God bless each one of you, and happy feast to all our priests. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share in his divinity, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness with this wine which we offer you, fruit of the wine and work of human hands, it'll become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to be pleased. Receive the sacrifice which we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash my iniquity, cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of blessed John Marie Vianney, that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. John Marie Vianney, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. You teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. So with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise. Without end we acclaim. Now in the canon, as I say, the Mass. Keep them in your mind. We pray for all of them. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, by our cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. We'll pray for all the departed. Remember your servants and handmaids, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they, who were united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who've died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John Marie Vianney, with all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be bequeathed eternal life, praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, to you, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be all glory and honor forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress. We wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity. In accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer the sign of peace. Christ's peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed John Marie Vianney, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation that you trace for us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass ended. Let's go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God bless each one of you, and a happy feast to all our priests if you're participating, especially the parish priests. Pray for each other. I'll pray for you. Pray for me. And all of you, let's pray for our priests today. Today is John Marie Vianney Day. On Sunday, again, we'll remember them in a very special way. And have a lovely day. God bless you.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic and be available to all. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I thank my God. Spotless as the host that daily.